spiritual fireworks. We come expecting, so whether you're here in the parking lot of our outdoor sanctuary at Encounter Church, or you're on Facebook, or you're on YouTube, or our website, come on, unbuckle, because we're ready to go places in God. He has a special word for us. Apostle is carrying something for us today. So we're going to give God the glory, honor, and praise. Go ahead and engage. Hit that share button. Go ahead and comment and like.
Oh, Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. People of every nation and tongue, from generation to generation, we worship you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you for who you are.
Oh, we worship.
We worship you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you for who you are. For you are good.
God, he's our deliverer.
We worship you, for I've tasted.
sing with me. Freedom reigns in this place. Showers of mercy and grace falling on every face. There is freedom.
With hands lifted high, voices to the sky. Freedom,
freedom.
Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom.
You at home, sing with us.
There is freedom. Oh, where the Spirit.
Freedom, freedom.
Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there
freedom.
Is freedom.
No bondage, freedom.
There is freedom. Freedom reigns in this place.
Church.
There is freedom.
He's here right now.
When the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. When the Spirit of the Lord is,
your hands toward me all over this open air heaven. You at home, stretch your hands toward me as we make contact with each other in unity and in faith. Father, we thank you for another day of life. We thank you for another week of life. We thank you, Lord, for another Independence Day, Lord God. Father, we pray that your kingdom will come today and your will be done today on this, the Sabbath, your Lord's Day. Father, we pray today that you would be honored, magnified, and glorified through our hearts, through the way we think, through the way we act, through the way we respond. May you be honored, magnified, and glorified this day. Father, we pray for healings in this house. We pray for healings, everybody watching, wherever they happen to be. We pray that from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, that you are being made whole and healed now. We ask you, Holy Spirit, to go into that room, go into that heart. Holy Spirit, go into that blood vessel. Holy Spirit, go into that blood vessel. Holy Spirit, go into that. Holy Spirit, go into that cancer cell. Holy Spirit, go into that heart. Holy Spirit, go into that murmur. Holy Spirit, go into that artery, I pray. Holy Spirit, right now we ask that you bring healing through the blood of Jesus. For the word of the Lord says, if the same Spirit who raised Christ from the dead, he who dwells in you shall quicken your mortal body. So Holy Spirit, invade people's minds. Father, we pray through the Holy Spirit's power, in the mighty name of Jesus, eliminate fear, eliminate hurt, eliminate discouragement, eliminate injustice, eliminate anger, eliminate bitterness, eliminate jealousy, eliminate cancer, eliminate heart disease. Father, eliminate disunity. Father, I declare for those watching and those here right now, for healing through the power of the Holy Spirit, healing through the power of the name of Jesus, healing through the power of the blood of Jesus. We declare your church well. We declare your people well, from the crown of their head to the soles of their feet. We stand in proxy for our family. We stand in proxy for our loved ones. Your healing touch even now, Lord God. Father God, for those in prison cells, Lord God, incarcerated in the natural and incarcerated in the spiritual. Incarcerated in the natural and incarcerated in the spiritual. Father, set free those who are bound, we pray. In the name of the Lord Jesus, for the lonely, the outcast, the sick, the shut-in, the bereaved, Lord God, you're healing even now, Father God. Father, we pray for our president. We pray from the White House to our house. Father God, for unity, strength, courage, boldness, wisdom. Father God, for America, I miss 4th of July, Independence Day, Lord God. Father, we pray for racial reconciliation. We pray for healing in our land, healing in America. You said, Lord, if my people, not any people, but my people, if my people who represent me and call by my name will humble, I can pray all I want. I can pray all I want. I can yell all I want. But if there's no humility, God will not answer me. If there's no humility, I will not get heaven's attention. If my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and seek my face, not just my hand. His hand will touch you, but his face will change you. His hand will touch you, but his face will change you. If my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves, seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, my people turning from their wicked ways, then and only then will they hear from heaven. And I will heal their land. I will heal Bartlett. I will heal Elgin. I will heal Rockford. I will heal Streamwood, Hanover Park. I will heal this region. I will heal America. I will heal the nations. Father, we pray that you do it according to 2 Chronicles 7:14. Do it, Lord. Yes, yes, yes. Do it, Lord. Unite us. Father, I pray for a revival of unity, a revival that the mercies of the Lord will melt people's hearts. That revival, Lord God, will come and mercy will melt hard hearts. Mercies will melt hard hearts. Mercies will melt those who have walked away from you, who've ran away from you. Mercies will melt, Lord God. I tell you, it's hot up here. Talking in the Holy Ghost, it's hot up here. The explosion of God's power to bring healing and deliverance. We believe it now, Father. For you at home, we believe it now. For you at home, we believe it now. In Jesus' mighty name, for all these people, Satan, the Lord rebuke you. Satan, the Lord rebuke you. Every principality, every power, every ruler of darkness in high place, come down. Every wickedness on high, come down. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. Jesus the Christ is the Lord, the King of kings and the Lord of lords. And everything that has a name has to bow. Everything that has a name has has to bow. And we give you the glory, Father. People of God, the anointing is strong. Father, I thank you for these darlings. Darlings, I hear the Lord say, darlings. You're not just anybody. You're the darlings of the Lord. You're the darlings of the Lord. Touch these darlings, Lord, we pray. In Jesus' name. And today we give you the glory, Father God, in Jesus' name. You alone are holy. You alone are worthy. Look at his face only, his face. You deserve the glory. Jesus, tell him.
Jesus, you alone.
Look in his face and sing.
You alone are holy.
You alone.
You alone are worthy.
You deserve the glory.
You deserve the glory. Jesus, you alone.
Baby, come here 1 second, love. Come here. Come here, baby. Come here, baby. Come here, lover girl. How beautiful. Come here, sweetie. Come here, baby. Come here, come here, come here, come here, baby. It's okay. Hi, mama. Good, mama. How are you? Look in that camera. What do you get? That right there. We'll get her in. We'll get her. This is Mama Ginola. This is Mama Ginola. Is she beautiful?
She is.
She beautiful. Come here, baby. Look, you come on this side here. Mama Ginola is so beautiful. And this beautiful young lady is? Yeah. Tell me your name again.
Her name is Serenity.
Serenity. Oh, my Lord. Hold this, babe.
Yes.
God hold you, baby. It's okay. It's okay.
Serenity, I remember over 1 year and 5 months ago, you used to be in church inside. It's okay, look at how beautiful she is. And before COVID, she'd be in service with us and Patricia and Johnny and Patricia Robinson. This is their grandbaby.
Yes.
This is your great-grandbaby. Oh, my Lord. Look at her now. Look at her. Isn't she beautiful?
She's gorgeous.
She's beautiful, isn't she? We speak blessings over all the children today.
Yes.
And that they will grow up in a society of knowing what this day is about for them. That they would know liberty and justice for all. For all of our children.
Yes.
For all of our children. That we would be able to be proud to say we are an America, an American. That we pray, Lord, for a united states, not a divided states. Serenity, huh?
Yes.
What a name. How prophetic that is. Blessings upon her, Lord, and upon all of our children this day, on this Independence Day, in Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thank you, Serenity. Love you so much. Mama, love you so much.
Yes.
And you always look so pretty.
You do. She's sharp.
She asked me one day. She said, it's okay. She asked me one day, she said, Pastor, she says, if you think about it, find me a nice Italian man. Find me a nice Italian man. And I've been looking, and I found a lot of Italian men, but I have to find one just right, just for her.
Just for
because
her.
Because she's a special woman.
Yes.
She's a special woman.
Yes.
Well, give Mama and give Serenity here a big God bless you today. Would you do it? And I love your shoes there, Mama Ginola. Boy, you are hip. You are, and you got your America shirt on. I love it. Alabama. Jesse. Look at this. Alabama, Alaska, Arizona, Arkansas, California, Colorado, Delaware, Florida, Georgia, Hawaii, Indiana, Iowa, North Dakota, Kansas, Kentucky, Louisiana, Ohio, Oregon, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island. Hey, you know what the biggest pencil in the world is?
No.
You know what the biggest pencil in the world is?
No.
Pennsylvania. All right. Let's see who else. We have Missouri, Montana, Nebraska. Guys, we're prophesying right now. We've got Missouri, Montana, Nebraska, North Dakota, Tennessee, Texas, Utah, New Jersey, New Hampshire, Nevada, New Mexico, New York. New York City. Where?
New York City.
New York, North Carolina. We have Virginia, Washington, West Virginia, yes. Wisconsin,
blessed,
Wyoming.
Yes, blessed.
Look at this. U.S. Virgin Islands. We got them all up there. Massachusetts. Look at that. Vermont. Everything. Everything. We pray blessings over every state.
Yes.
But this is ordained by God. You can't make this up.
Really?
You cannot make this up. We pray that every state. See, we're not looking for red states and blue states. Come on, somebody.
Come on, somebody. That's right.
We're not looking for red states and blue states.
Oh, no.
We're not looking for delegates. We're looking for honoring the King of Kings. And we're not looking for blue states or red states. We're looking to be the United States. I know you agree. Give the Lord a high, healthy, heavenly, holy honk if you're worthy or not.
Bless.
Oh, that's good. You can't make this up. You can't make this up.
I love it. The United States. Good morning, everybody.
That was
God
good.
Bless you.
Thanks,
yes,
Mama, for wearing
that.
Thanks for wearing that shirt.
Oh, thank you.
All right.
The children's ministry is taking place. You can take your kids right under the awning and the canopy and sign your kids in. And we just want to acknowledge all those who are visiting with us today, whether you're online or in the parking lot. God bless you. Welcome. Welcome to Encounter Church. If you don't have a church home that you could call home, we welcome you home to Encounter Church. And God bless you once again for being with
That's
us.
That's right. I was a visitor here myself.
At one time you were, right?
40-something years ago. Uh-huh. Even before most of you were born. Even before. Uh-huh. That's true.
You can say that now, yeah, right?
Even before most of you were born, I came to Chicago and they welcomed me. I love the people of the Midwest.
I know.
I love they have broad shoulders.
Yep.
And they welcome me, so now we welcome you.
Yes, we welcome you with open arms. All those who have July birthdays and July anniversaries, God bless you. God bless you, each and every one. Every anniversary, God bless you. May this year be a year like none other, we pray. And also, this past Wednesday in the morning, Apostle had an opportunity to minister in India through Facebook Live, through Zoom. And it was so cool with Ram Bamboo, who's been with us before, Rambo. And it was the coolest thing. And even though it was 9 o'clock in the morning for us, it was evening for them. And it was amazing. It was astounding what took place. The healings that took place. Later on, we talked to Ram Bamboo. And he told us about the things that God did through the airwaves. So it was so cool what God did from Chicago to India. Isn't that so neat? And I love it. There's no limits and no boundaries, especially that area, right? So to God be the glory what took place that morning. And may India ever be changed. Precious, precious India. And if you want, you could still view it on Facebook Live. You could go right to Jim DePalma, and it's right there on Facebook Live. And I believe if you view it and watch it, you'll be super blessed. Amen. All righty, this past Wednesday, we had our drive-in Wednesday night service, which was very, very cool.
Oh, it was good. It was cool.
And the youth and the young adults and the children all met, and it was great. And speaking about them, what a powerful move of the Spirit. I know we posted it on Facebook, what God did in the hearts and lives of the kids. And we're so blessed for them and so blessed what God did in their lives. And you could, of course, go to Facebook and check it out. And very, very cool how God touched them. Really, the Holy Spirit touched them.
Yes.
And we believe with our prayers and our perseverance and our prayer that God is going to continue that awesome work in our kids' lives. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
We also have a little snippet of that.
There's a snippet of it on Facebook Live.
On Facebook. Mm-hmm. And then go to Jim DePalma. We just show a little clip of Pastor Eddie
ministering.
Mm-hmm. And they had an encounter with the Holy Spirit.
They sure did. It was very precious.
Yes.
Very powerful and precious at the same time. This Wednesday, we're having our Facebook Live. It's going to be at 7 o'clock. And it's just going to be our Facebook Live service. So you'll want to tune in for that. The youth and young adults will have their Zoom. And it's going to be awesome.
Mm-hmm.
And at 7:20 is when our youth and young adults will have their Zoom.
So, guys, there's some more room in the overflow there. There's some more room back in the overflow there as well. And also, you were speaking about, where'd you leave off?
I left off at 7:20, the youth and young adults.
Oh, yeah. So there will not be a service here in the parking lot.
Right.
On Wednesday night, this coming Wednesday night, there will not.
It will be Facebook Live only.
Although this past Wednesday was awesome, wasn't it, Pastor?
It was.
It really was.
Alan, it was pretty good, huh? Yeah, it gives me a thumb up.
Enjoyed it.
Yes.
It was very, very neat. Mm-hmm. Okay, next Sunday will be our 10 o'clock service, and it will be a drive-in service. And we're going to have Holy Communion next Sunday.
Next Sunday, Holy Communion.
So it'll be really special. If in the event it rains, we're just going to take it inside. So there's no reason to not come out because you could still tune in, be in the parking lot and still tune in to 88.5 or Facebook Live. Otherwise, you could come on in. Mask or no mask, it's up to you. Because according to CDC recommendations, they say that that's how we're supposed to do it. So that's how we'll do it. Yep.
And then at the end of service, if anyone's out here or if anyone's inside, we'll all meet together.
And we'll all meet together
under
still.
Under the canopy.
Together
as one team.
Driving through.
Mm-hmm. So we win-win.
Yes.
So no excuse to stay home.
No excuse. Check your emails to stay up to speed on
Unless
things.
Unless you live out of state.
That's right.
And some of you who live out of state, if you want to move in state, we welcome you as well.
Yes, that's true.
Okay.
Beautiful. God bless you. I love you. Bless you. Love you.
Love you too. Thanks, babe. Uh-huh. And also, again, folks, I can't thank you enough for loving me the way you do and blessing me the way you do, for Father's Day, for my birthday, for every single blessing, no matter how it came. Thank you, each and every one, for all the blessings. Appreciate it so, so very much. All right. We have to talk today about the mercies of the Lord. I keep having encounters and encounters and encounters with the mercies of the Lord. I have encounters with the mercies of the Lord. Now, God's word tells us that the preaching of the word is what God's word tells us. Listen very carefully. The preaching of the word is to bring edification to the church. Kind of like prophecy. The preaching of the word is to bring edification to the church. The preaching of the word is to bring rebuke. This is what the word says. The preaching of the word is to bring rebuke to the church. The preaching of the word is to comfort the church. So that's why sometimes you'll hear things that are said that comfort us. Or sometimes things that challenge us. Sometimes there may be a rebuke. Or sometimes there may be an extra comforting word. And we have to have it all to live a healthy, balanced Christian life. So therefore, people like myself sometimes will say things that can make you laugh. And by making you laugh, you could say, well, he's funny. I like that. In fact, I like what he says. I like what he does. I like him. And that's a danger. Because if you like somebody by their performance, I'm prophesying now. This is not in my notes. But if you like somebody by their performance, then you manipulated their spirit and their walk with God. And manipulation really is a curse. The Bible in Galatians 6 says, who has manipulated you? The Bible calls that a form of witchcraft. That if we like people based on their performance, for instance, if you like sports and your team loses And all of a sudden you start trashing your team because they lost one game. They lost one game. You start trashing your team because they lost one game. But yet they won 50 other games. But they lost that one game. You start trashing them. I want to tell you, you are not a true fan. Now, do we get frustrated with our teams? Of course we do. Do we get upset? Of course we do. But you see where I'm going. So we must not like and enjoy each other's company based on that person. He acknowledged me. Therefore, because he acknowledged me, I really like him. Well, she did not acknowledge me. Didn't she know that it was my birthday today and she didn't even come up to me? Yeah, I got the card in the mail. So what? Everybody gets the card in the mail. But she didn't come up to me. So I don't like her today. And that's what the Bible calls manipulation, which is as the sin of witchcraft. Well, he said something today that really favors me. I really like him a lot. Well, he said something today that does not favor me. I don't like him a lot. And I'm not just referring to myself, I'm referring to life in general. Now, why am I saying all this? Because I'm about to tell you something that some of you will really enjoy hearing. But some of you will not enjoy hearing. And you who are parents know how that rolls. As parents, you know how that rolls. Because sometimes you say things to your kids, and one of your children may like it, and the other may not like it. Well, it's no different in the body of Christ. No different from me to you and you to me. Sometimes I'll say things that you want to hear. Sometimes I'll say things that you do not want to hear. Sometimes I'll say things that you agree with. Sometimes I'll say things you disagree with. But I'm going to speak the truth. So long as I stay with the Word of God, I will speak the truth. So I encourage you to agree, even if you disagree. If I speak the Word and I declare the Word, what's there to disagree with? So let's agree together, because I'm about to share some things today that, again, this is not to be political. Nope. This is not to take sides. No. We are one church. We are one unit. We are one body. And frankly, we are one race. Somebody comment. We are one race. At least when it comes to the kingdom. At least in the eyes of God, we are one race. In the eyes of God, we are one kingdom. The establishment of this earth has changed things around. So again, I'm going to get right into it, because I'm sharing today about mercy. The subject, the theme, and the way of life is mercy. So I ask you all to show mercy, to receive mercy by some of the things or by everything I have to share today. And if I say anything that gets under your skin, then you ought to check to see if you crucified your flesh today. If the Apostle Paul said, I die daily, he did not mean every other Tuesday. He meant even this morning. So if our flesh is crucified today, then there's no right or reason to challenge or get upset or be angry, because I speak the word of the Lord. Without honking your horn, can I get a loud amen?
Amen.
All right. Let's talk about mercy. Without reading it, because I know what it says, in 1 Corinthians 9:22. Now remember, I'm going to start sharing things, but your mind with 6,200 thoughts, although I lay the foundation, what I'm about to say may cause you to revert back to the ways of the thinking of the flesh. That's why we have to crucify it, not every day. That's just the start, sometimes every minute. But I speak to you in love, and I speak to you the word of the Lord for the sake of unity in our community. For unity and oneness, so that we can continue to come and reason together and remain a healthy church. Next month in August, for 1 week, next month in August, I will be ministering in New York. I'll be ministering in New York next month. In fact, now that I think of it, this month, Daryl Strawberry will be with us on the 25th. On the 25th of this month, Daryl Strawberry, baseball great, future Hall of Famer, All-Star World Series champion, Daryl Strawberry will be with us on the 25th of July. But in August, I will be ministering for a week in New York, and I have some words to share with some churches. I really do. God's bringing me there apostolically to realign some things for them and to get them back on track where they need to be. But when I'm there, I'm telling you right now, Encounter Church, while I'm there, I will say publicly, and you know this in advance right now on the 4th of July, but in a month from now, I will say publicly in these churches that I minister in New York City and Long Island, New York, I will tell them that I pastor one of the healthiest, strongest, united churches in America. That's a compliment to you. I give God the glory, but that's a compliment to you. I will let New York know that I pastor not the biggest church, not the smallest church, but I pastor one of the healthiest, strongest, united churches, we're not perfect, in the United States of America. Why would I say that? To encourage others to follow our example, to follow your example. But none of us are perfect. Starting from the pulpit to the pew, none of us are perfect. I'm going to let them know that. Okay. In 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 22, here's what the Apostle Paul said. He said, I've learned. In other words, it's a process. It's a test. I've learned to become all things to all men. I'll say it again. I've learned to become all things to all men. Now, mind you, we're talking about mercy. Mind you, I lay the foundation of what I'm sharing to receive it with an open heart. But Paul the Apostle said in 1 Corinthians 9:22, I've learned to become all things to all men. So I want to ask you a question. Are you learning to become all things to all men? Are we learning? Is our country learning? Encounter Church, all of us. Now, I just bragged about you, so you're in a good place. But are we at the place where we need to be? I believe we're at a good place, but I believe there's a lot more growing to do in me and you and all of us. Talking about God's mercy now. So Paul the Apostle says in 1 Corinthians 9:22, he says, I've learned to become all things to all men. Listen to this. He said, to the Jews, I've learned to become a Jew. To think like a Jew. Listen to me. This is good stuff. To act like a Jew. To the Gentiles, I've learned how to think like a Gentile. I've learned to act like a Gentile. Very careful, folks. It's very, very interesting. Very interesting. He says, to a person who thinks a certain way, listen to this, to a person who thinks a certain way or acts a certain way, I've learned to understand. This is deep. I've learned to understand why she thinks the way she thinks. That requires maturity. That requires being teachable. That requires living in somebody else's skin. That requires empathy. That requires compassion. Bottom line, that requires mercy. And the Apostle Paul, in today's vernacular, would say, I've learned how to live like a white man and understand the white culture. I've learned how to live like a black man or woman, or African-American. I've learned their culture, and I understand how they think without being them, because I've learned how to become all things to all men by the process of the Holy Spirit working in me. I've learned how to be Asian, although I'm not Asian. I've learned how to be tall. I've learned how to be short. I've learned how certain individuals have their delicacies. Who today after church is going to have Puerto Rican food? Who's going to have soul food? Who's going to have Americanized food? Hamburgers, hot dogs. And Paul the Apostle was saying, I've learned in the course of time, I've asked the Holy Spirit, Paul said, to show me how I can reach everybody. I've learned how to think like a Republican. I've learned how to think like a Democrat. But I've learned how to act like a Christian toward all of the above. Every race, color, and creed. Are you with me? Good. Got your air conditions on. Smart. Some of you are sitting outside. Get a nice tan. Now here we are, folks, and I know you're listening so well. Thank you. That's one thing you do well. You do a lot of things well. So here we are now. It's Independence Day. Independence Day, 4th of July. Fireworks going off. Some of you may notice I'm wearing red, white, and blue. I'm even wearing red shoes. I'm wearing red shoes. Red top, blue shirt, white pants. Why? Because I'm representing the states of America that we believe will be the United States of America. As I read earlier, when Mama Ginola was wearing her shirt, we prayed for the states, United States, to be united. But let me give us all something to think about by the leading of the Holy Spirit. Everything I'm sharing this morning, I share by the leading of the Holy Spirit. If a man or woman of God stands behind a pulpit, any pulpit, and is not led by the Holy Spirit, then something is wrong. The village of Bartlett contacted me on Friday afternoon. The village of Bartlett, this village here. They have a big festival going on right now as I speak. Huge. Tens and thousands of people throughout the course of the few days are there. But the village of Bartlett called me on, they emailed me on Friday. And they asked for this month, they gave me the date, if I would go there to the village hall, which I've done before, as you know. In fact, I was voted Bartlett's favorite pastor, three, four years ago?
Yeah, 3-4 years.
They named me Bartlett's favorite pastor, and that's okay. I don't get a big head over that, and I don't get a small head. I just do what God's called me to do. In other words, I don't get an enlarged ego over it, and nor do I minimize with false humility. That's what I mean. But they have asked me specifically to go on a certain night this month and impart to them a prayer of unity and reconciliation. So God's given me a platform in this region. He's given me a platform in India, in New York. Why? Why has He given me a platform? Because He knows that what I say has influence on people. Now, folks, if we do not have influence on people, not talking about controlling people, no. But having influence on them. You see, the only way we'll reach people to the Lord is by having some kind of influence. And the only way you can have influence, it's not necessarily by being influential, meaning having a lot of money or driving a nice car. How many know a lot of money and driving a nice car does not heal a broken heart? It does not heal a broken heart. But to have influence means that you're going to be the one not to condemn that other person. You're going to be the one not to throw stones at that other person. You're going to be the one not to cast judgment on that other person. But look what she did. How many times is she going to mess up? Look what he did. How many times is he going to mess up? Influence, true, godly, biblical, profound influence comes when we display mercy. But genuine mercy is becoming all things to all men. But the only way you can become all things to all men is when you have an encounter with individuals who are not like you. I'll say it again. to have an encounter with individuals who are not like you. And the only way you can have an encounter with individuals and having influence on them who are not like you is by extending an olive branch, by extending mercy. You've heard me share this before, and I still have to, because we in America are still dealing with the ramifications. But I told you months in advance before the presidential election, I prophesied. I said, read my lips. I even said, if this does not come to pass, may the Lord take me home before my 64th birthday. Talk about life and death and the power of the tongue. I prophesied to you way before the elections. I said, this will be the worst election in American history. And I says, I'm speaking thus saith the Lord, and if it doesn't come to pass, may the Lord take me home to prove that I'm a false prophet before my 64th birthday. Well, why would I say something like that, may the Lord take me home? Because I was confident, I was assured that I knew I heard from God. And we all know what happened. Everywhere, from the capital to this city to that city, and around America and around the world. I had people from other countries, literally from Europe and other countries, contact me, text me, email me, call me from other countries on WhatsApp. They would call me and they said, Jim, what in the world is happening to your country? Some said, we're supposed to be the dysfunctional ones, meaning their country. Their country is supposed to be the dysfunctional ones. They're saying, we have more unity in our dysfunctional country than you have in yours. Now stay focused. This is the 4th of July, Independence Day. But we have to have influence. And the only way we'll have influence is by not bringing judgment. Some people say, well, he must be in a bad mood the way he's preaching today. Hold on. Have you walked in his shoes? Have you walked in her shoes? Do you feel his heartbeat? Do you feel her heartbeat? See, mercy does not look at natural illustrations and makes a judgment by natural actions. Mercy looks beyond the natural and sees by the Spirit. That's why the Bible says love never fails. Love is ever ready to believe the truth about all things. Here's where I'm going. Many today are celebrating Independence Day. Many are pledging allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. I appreciate that. I thank God that I'm an American. I thank God I am an American. I thank God that I was born in this country. It's a shame. It's a disgrace what has happened to our nation. It is a shame. It's a disgrace what's happening in local churches. It's a shame. But I believe the word of the Lord still says, come, let us reason together, says the Lord. I still believe the word of the Lord says, and that's Isaiah 1, 18, 19. I believe the word of the Lord still says in Psalm 133, how good, behold, take a picture, how good and pleasant it is for brothers and sisters to come together and dwell together in unity. Like oil being poured down the beard of Aaron, yes, Aaron the high priest. For there the Lord commanded, Shavah, commanded blessings and life forevermore. I still believe in that word, even though I preached it 4 months ago, 5 months ago, I still believe it stands today. It stands today. So while many today are dressed in their red, white, and blue, even during the elections, I've heard some Christians saying, I wish I lived in another country, born again, spirit-filled Christians. I wished I lived in Canada. I wish I lived in another state, another country. And many Christians were quick to judge.
During the election, we were quick to take sides. And let me remind you one more time, respectfully, I'll say them by first name, respectfully. Donald Trump did not die for America. Joe Biden did not die for America. And it marveled me how tens and thousands of Christians came together in prayer for a man to be put in an office for a short season, as opposed to coming to God on their face with a spirit of humility, judging their own hearts and crying out to God for revival. That's why I'm so grateful I'm not a Democrat nor a Republican. Back in the day in the 70s, we called ourselves Jesus freaks. Maybe I'll call myself a Jesus freak once again. But here's where I'm going. I told you today I'm dressed in red, white, and blue, as you can see. Patriotic. But not every American feels today patriotic. Let's stay on course. We're talking about the mercies of God. Not every Christian today feels patriotic. Not every Christian. Not every Christian wants to salute the flag. I know I'm rolling up some stuff here, but that's okay. Because this is the year of dealing with roots. Ecclesiastes 10:10 says, it's time to sharpen the axe so it's no longer dull. I want your mind to be sharpened with the word of God. I want your spirit to be sharpened with the word of God. And your body to be in divine health. But we must deal with the roots. With the roots. God has not called us to side take with our favorite team or our favorite race or rally. He's called us to unite together as one family. And Paul said, I'm all things to all men. But not everyone in America today is celebrating their freedom. Why? Because some are still locked up. Some are still in bondage. Many are still in bondage. Many homeless. Many single mothers. Many poor people are in bondage. Many people of color are in bondage. Many individuals, regardless of their color, are in bondage. Now, America became a nation when? 4th of July, right? What year? Does anyone know what year? What year? What year did we become a nation? Come on, we're in America now. Come on, we're not in England. We're not in China. We're not in Italy. What year did we become a nation? Comment, what year? Can I hear anybody? Nobody knows? 1776. It's okay, it took you a while. It's okay. Mercy. Mercy. July 4th, 1776. Hear me very carefully. And remember, I laid a strong foundation, so I warned you. Because if anyone's about to get upset, you're in trouble. Not with me, but with God, and you walk with God. July 4th, 1776, we become a nation called the United States of America. Here we are today, July 4th, 2021, which means today is our birthday. Happy birthday, America. Happy birthday, Americans. Happy birthday, Encounter Church, who's part of America. Today, we have become 245 years old. 245 years today is our birthday. Much has happened in 245 years. Much has happened. And if I start giving you a list of one thing, I may be tempted to give you a list of many other things which can keep us here for quite some time. But again, 1776, July 4th. Here we are today, July 4th, 2021. Do the math. We are now 245 years old Now catch this very carefully. I told you there'd be some spiritual fireworks here today. You didn't realize it was going to be this hot, did you? I told you. 245 years old today. Here we go. Slavery. Slavery among Africans. African Americans. Theoretically, and I underline theoretically, ended in what year? Anybody know? 1865. 1865, theoretically. So if you take, folks, 1776, we're dealing with roots here, folks. We're dealing with roots. You'll never have influence on anyone until you deal with roots. If all you see is the fruit and blame a person for this and blame a person for that, whatever dealing with the root, you're just as guilty. You're just as lost, if that would be. So if you do the math from 1776, 245 years later, here we are today, slavery technically abolished 1865, do the math, you have 89 years from the time of the inception of our freedom or supposed freedom. Now, I said already, some of you may really like what I'm saying, some of you may not, but I'm giving you the truth, and the truth will set you free. Take it up with God. Trump can't bail you out on this one, nor can Joe Biden. But the word of God is here on this 4th of July to give Encounter Church and this region and the nations a fresh revelation. And this is why the village of Bartlett has asked me to come. This is why New York City is asking me to come. In fact, they're asking me to come back again. Two trips. India again. Why? Because when you have influence, people want to hear what you have to say. And again, we're not talking about influential, meaning you have to have a big name or a big car or a lot of money. It means to show mercy and meet people where they're at. Because mercy triumphs over judgment. So here we are from 1776, and slavery abolished in 1865, which means a continuation from the birth of America. You're not going to hear this much today, but you're going to hear it here. You'll hear it other places, but not many. So while we're celebrating our independence, fireworks, red, white, and blue, for 89 plus years, your brothers and sisters of perhaps a different color and a different race were still segregated and in bondage. And you wonder why some today, hear me very carefully and don't hear what I'm not saying. And you wonder why some people today have a problem saluting their flag. And I'm not for it. I'm telling you the truth of why it's happening. Hear me. Don't hear me. See, a religious person, or the religious, and you can speak in tongues till you're blue in the face and still have a religious demon, if that be anybody. But all some people see is their side, and they build their case on their side and their side only. That's not the gospel I read. The gospel I read says in 1 Corinthians 9:27, to the black I became black, to the brown I became brown, to the oppressed I became oppressed. For those served injustice, I became them. For those who walk in love, I became them. For those that experience sickness and disease, I wanted to understand what they were going through. But many in America today have a difficult time saluting the flag. They have a hard time when we get to the point where it says, for liberty and justice for all. For all. Who's all? Who's all? White suburban America? Who's all? I'm not trashing my race. I'm teaching you how to have mercy and become all things to all men. And this last presidential election was a disgrace to the church. and even some of you on Facebook, shame on you! You are not a Christian representative of Christ. You are not a Christ ambassador. You have bastard seed in you. Call it out what it is. It's bastard seed. Call it out what it is, what the Bible calls it. Cast it out. Because I want America to be free. I want America to be one nation under God. Listen, I'm white. I know how white folk think. But by the grace of God, He's taught me and is teaching me. He's teaching me. My children, thank God, they can all think normally on their own. They can hold jobs, have relationships with people. But then we have families in our church that their children are challenged in certain areas. And we have to think about them and what they're going through. What that marriage is going through. What that family is going through. 89 years for slavery to supposedly come to an end. Yet here we are in 2021 and we still have injustice. And I'm not bashing my race. I don't wrestle with flesh and blood. I'm not bashing the Democratic Party or Republican Party. I don't wrestle with flesh and blood. But as an apostle, I speak what God shows me. And as a prophet, I declare what God says for me to say. Why? So that we could be a merciful people. A merciful church. So that all Americans can say, with liberty and justice for all. As we had that little baby up here earlier.
Serenity.
Serenity. What a name. Serenity. That all can walk in serenity. I want to tell you something else. I was waiting on the Lord to see if I should say this. We have folk in this church that are Democrats. We have folk in this church that are Republicans. This is going to trip some of your minds because you've been on the other side of the tracks too long. And when you're on the other side of the tracks too long, you only think like those who are on the other side of the tracks. But the people of Encounter Church, the people that I pastor, the people that I'm their spiritual father, the people who write me cards and say, I love you, or speak it out, I love you. We are a church that stands for morality. And we have Democrats in our church that stand for morality and only morality. And some have judged them, prejudged them, shook their heads saying, but how can they vote so-and-so? If they're pro-life, let me tell you something about the African-American community. And the African-Americans under my watch, even more importantly. Everyone in this parking lot, everyone who says they're a member of this church, I promise you, regardless of who they voted for, they're as pro-life more than most white evangelicals. Now I'm saying that to make a point to bring us to a balance. To bring us to a balance. But we've learned to label people without hearing their hearts. Without understanding, so we label people. It's called judgmentalism. It's called lack of empathy. It's called lack of compassion. And I'm not here to bash my race. I'm not here to bash anybody's race. But I am here today on Independence Day to say it's time for all America to be united and for each and every one of us, including Serenity, to receive liberty and justice for all. 1 Corinthians 9:22. So that we can become all things to all men. In James 2:13 is our text. I'm going to close in a few minutes. For there will be no mercy to those who show no mercy. Let me intervene by saying, wouldn't it be nice, Lord willing, next presidential election? Because word's already out about who's going to be running or who may be running, or is it going to be him in office, her in office? And already people are talking about the Jezebels and the Jezebels and the Maybells and everything. I get it. I understand. I live in the same world as you. But wouldn't it be great if we paid back our poor testimony from this last election, and in 3.5 years from now, or however many years, we as the church would stand and say, we're the church. You're my brother. You're my sister. Take me by the hand. Folks, we're not talking about universalism. We're not talking about a false doctrine. We're talking about the real church showing mercy and compassion to each other without judging. How many people left churches on bad notes, speaking ugly about their pastors? Shame. Whether they did something right or wrong, shame. How many people? I hear people telling me sometimes, you know, would you pray that I get a job? I said, wait a minute, you just got a job. Yeah, I don't have that job anymore. Okay, I pray. A week later, would you pray I get a job? Oh, wait a minute, you just got it. Yeah, I just got another job. When you learn to respect authority, whether you agree with them or disagree with them, so long as you put God first and the principles of God's word first, the Bible says, honor all men as unto the Lord. And if your flesh has a hard time with it, if your political association has a hard time with it, then do it for the sake of the Lord, which is really for your sake and for my sake. So guys, please, let me intervene. I did not mean to preach at you today. I'm not trying to tiptoe through the tulips, as you could see. But I'm sure not here to preach at you today. But when you're an apostle, you see things. When you're a prophet, you see things. And I see by the Spirit what it's going to take to sharpen the sword, to sharpen the axe, to deal with the roots. And today I've given you one illustration. And that doesn't mean we favor anybody. No one's asking to be favored. No one's asking for a handout. Not here. But it's time to have justice for all. For all. And all means all. Red, yellow, black, white, him, her, them. Justice for all. Whether you agree or disagree. Wouldn't it be great come the next election? I heard a rumor the other day. And you know what they say about rumors. But that Governor Prixner here of the state of Illinois, he may not be running another term. I could hear some people saying, oh, thank you, Lord. I could hear some people saying, oh, my God, what's going to happen now? Is a Republican going to take office? People of God, these things are not to be. We represent the kingdom of God, not the kingdom of man. And we need to think like kingdom people. And I prophesied last Sunday, and I prophesied on Wednesday, and I'm going to prophesy right now. There's going to come a revival to America. And I don't say things to say things. There's going to come a revival to America where thousands will be won to the Lord, not by Benny Hinn crusades. And thank you, Benny. I love you. I love your Pastor Benny. Not through Billy Graham. Thank you, Lord, for Billy Graham in heaven. Not through Oral Roberts. Thank you, Lord, for Oral Roberts. Thank you, Lord, for Bishop Jakes. Love you, Bishop. But there's coming a revival that's going to be started with you that are standing right there next to your car. With you sitting in your vehicle right now in the air conditioning. With you engaging online at home. And the revival's going to be not another new doctrine. Not another hyper-prosperity gospel. We don't need that. Not another hyper-grace message. We don't need another. We don't need to argue when the Lord's going to return, pre-rapture, mid, post-trib, no rapture, rapture, second coming, no second coming, the abomination of desolation, no. The Lord's going to return, hear me, for a merciful people, a people that will go beyond looking at the natural and judging. Whether black against white, or white against black, but where we all come together in the bonds of love. In the bonds of love. I'm going to continue more on Wednesday, where your home in your air-conditioned house or apartment. But you remember the woman that was caught in adultery in John chapter 8. And all the religious folk of the church, you know, we call them the Pharisees and the Sadducees, but I don't like using that pertaining to today, because then it makes us think like, oh, that doesn't pertain to me. Let me tell you, if anything I said applies to you or brought conviction to you, thank the Lord for it. Because today in the church, we have many people that act like Pharisees, but refuse to call themselves Pharisee. But if you bring judgment upon me, or if I bring judgment upon you, or if you are critical of your neighbor, or critical of your friend, or critical of your employer. I told you about this guy, he can't hold a job for 6 days. Why? He's got a stinking attitude. He doesn't need prayer, he needs an attitude change. And we want America to wake up. And I want to see every American, red, yellow, black, and white, precious in his sight, representing our country with pride and dignity. When everybody gets a fair share, everybody gets a fair share. And I know what some of you still may be thinking. Renew your brain, would you? And think like Christ. Would you allow your mind to be succumbed with compassion? Would you allow your spirit to be succumbed with passion? Hear me. No one's looking for you to feel sorry for them. The people I know are not looking for handouts. You have that in every society. In fact, there are some in this parking lot today. There are some in this parking lot today asking for a handout. You say, what do you mean? You'll come to this church, you'll pray, you'll praise, and you'll worship, but you'll leave without giving a damn nickel. There's a covenant test right there, isn't there? You'll leave without giving a damn nickel. It's in the Bible. It's in the Bible. Let's be that church on this Independence Day. As I told you, His word comes to bring comfort, exhortation, rebuke. We need it all. If He's going to return for a glorious church without spot, blemish, or wrinkle. Because the only way you remove spots and wrinkles is by pressure. Pressure. Heat. Heat. You put an iron on something that needs to be pressed. That iron brings pressure. It brings heat. Today the heat is in the house in more ways than one. In fact, I believe the Lord's allowed this natural heat. I believe the Lord's allowed this natural heat to remind us that the fire of God is upon us. And I want us to celebrate our nation. No one that I know is looking to be catered to or felt sorry for. But we want justice for all. They started criticizing this woman caught in adultery. She was caught in the act. Don't try to dwell on that one, please. You could really have a vain imagination on that one. The woman was caught in the act of adultery. In the act. They came in the house or something. They peeked through the bedroom window. She was caught. And the religious folks, and I told you who the religious ones are in today's terminology, they said, aren't you going to stone her? Folks, listen to me. If it's you, if it's me, let's put our stones away. Let's start stoning devils. Let's start stoning devils. Let's form contingencies of groups that are willing to go to the south side of Chicago and the west side of Chicago and stand for the cross of Christ and intercede that this violence and murdering, it must stop now. That's what the church is for. It's not come to be entertained or to clap when you like what I say or don't like what I say and not clap or rate me or judge me or criticize me. That's manipulation, which is witchcraft. Now remember, I already told you I already told you that I'm going to New York and I'm going to be bragging about you, so I ain't taking it back. I ain't taking it back. But they said, Jesus, aren't you going to stone her? He started to write in the ground. He started to write in the ground. They were looking, huh? Like many Christians, huh? Show mercy, huh? You believe it? He's a Democrat, huh? She's a Republican, huh? Why don't you talk to your sister in the Lord and find out why she believes the way she does, and you'll find out that she believes just like you. So it's called Come, Let Us Reason Together. We're not talking about compromising. We're not talking about immorality. God forbid. So Jesus is writing on the ground. They're looking, huh? Like many today, huh? Huh? And Jesus said, he who's without sin, cast the first stone. And they all were humbled. And they all took their stones and they put them down. And he said, woman, go. You are forgiven. You are free. You are free. You are free. You get it? Freedom. Freedom. You are free. You get it? Freedom. The other woman was married 5 times. 5 times she was married. Oh, how would the church talk about her today? If she was a member of Encounter Church and she was married 5 times, how would we think? How would we respond? And Jesus said, not only were you married 5 times, he didn't do it to rub it in her face, he did it to remind her. Not only were you married 5 times, but the man you're living with is not your husband. Do the math. But what did Jesus say? Give me a drink of water. And she gave him something in the natural, and he gave her something in the supernatural. Today, on Independence Day, on the 4th of July, let us walk in the supernatural, and let us start with knowing that we have freedom and liberty that belongs to us. And if it was taken from you, stolen from you, may the Lord restore, replenish, and may we be the United States of America. And for every soldier, red, yellow, black, and white, that has paid a price for our country and your family, ma'am, sir, we at Encounter Church salute you today. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, please. I have hid behind the cross of Christ today as I've said everything that I've said. I dared not give you my opinion today. I dared not give you my opinion today. but I've given you nothing but 100% natural, uncompromising word of God. I hear the Lord saying to say to the church, and for what he's saying to us, to ask him. Somebody say, Lord, fix me. Come on, somebody comment. Somebody say, Lord, fix me.
Lord, fix me.
Say it again, come on.
Lord, fix me.
One of the things about being fixed is you have to realize you've been broken. Lord, fix us. Yes. Fix our nation, Lord, we pray.
Yes.
Fix, Lord, our nation, we pray. Red, white, and blue. Fix us, Lord. May we be a United States. I love my country. But I want everyone in my country to live with freedom and liberty and justice for all. Father God, where there's been injustice, Father God, we repent. We repent, Lord God. I repent as a pastor. I repent as a man of God. But most of all, I repent as a son of God. I repent as Jimmy. Father, cleanse me, cleanse us by the blood. That as the head goes, the body may follow. Cleanse us by the blood, Lord. Cleanse us all individually. And may we be agents of mercy that ushers in a great revival. Cleanse us by the blood. No condemnation, but cleanse us by the blood. May we be agents of love, agents of hope, agents of unity, agents of justice. Justice from the womb to the tomb. Agents of justice in Jesus' name. Peace, unity, strength, independence, dependent on God. In Jesus' name. You count the church, you're the best in the Midwest or anywhere else. Some of you watching, you say you're from Encounter, but you're really not. You just want to get on board without the commitment. That's what, you can still tune in. We still love you. We're here to show mercy. But then there are some of you that are not with us and you're watching. You're a part of Encounter. You got to be a part of a local church. You got to be a part of a local church. You got to be part of a family that cares for each other, that will love each other, that when you cry, we cry. When you laugh, we laugh. And remember, we are one body, one race, one kingdom, under God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Give the Lord a high, healthy, heavenly, holy honk to his glory today.
Freedom reigns in this place.
Declare it, showers.
Showers of mercy and grace.
To be able to say what the Apostle Paul said. I want to be able to say what the Apostle Paul said, and I know so do you. I want to become all things to all men. It starts by showing mercy. Doesn't mean you have to compromise. It means you have to show mercy. This word is now sealed. Babe, come up here quickly and seal this word. I know you've been taking notes. You've been what? Seal this word real quickly.
Heavenly Father, I pray, Lord Jesus, as the word went forth with great anointing, that it would be sealed by the precious anointing in the hearts and lives of each and every listener, each and every Encounter member, each and every viewer, each and every person, Father, man, woman, boy, or girl, in the name of Jesus. And may it bring great freedom and liberty to them, Lord. Thank you, Father God.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Father God.
Thank you, Lord.
For your anointing on this precious word.
For your anointing on this precious word. Real quickly, babe, what'd you learn today?
Oh, my. I just learned that 89 years of saying the Pledge of Allegiance and knowing that it wasn't really happening.
Yeah.
You know, it's just It's just saddening, but
we're believing for healing today.
Amen.
Complete healing.
Amen.
We've come a ways.
That's right. That's right.
But we have a ways to go.
But with knowledge comes power.
With knowledge comes power.
And with knowledge comes an understanding and knowing.
Yeah. And we're not wrestling with flesh and blood.
No, we're not.
No. You're from Chicago.
Because it's a root that's been exposed.
Yes.
It's a root that's been exposed.
Yes.
And now, because it's exposed, we have to do is just learn from it and grow from it.
Yes. Calvin Church, we thank you for your faithfulness to God with tithes and offerings.
Yes.
First fruits, oblations. We thank you for your faithfulness.
Yes.
I declared to you 3 or 4 weeks ago, multiplication. I'm going to say it again. Multiplication.
Amen.
In Calvin Church, thank you. But maybe there are some of you here today that you're not used to tithing.
Right.
You're not used to sowing.
Right.
If you're not used to tithing, if you're not used to sowing, then frankly, you're not used to being blessed.
Right.
And I want you to get used to being blessed.
Yes.
I don't want you to become familiarized with it, but I want you to be used to being healed.
Amen.
I want you to get used to walking in health.
Amen. Yeah. I love that.
I want you to get
great way to look at it.
I want you to get used to seeing your bills paid without running out of month before you run out of money.
Mm-hmm.
I want to see that. But it requires obedience.
Yes, it does.
Faith.
And trust.
And trust. Faith.
Yes.
He said, trust me now. I will open the windows of heaven. Prove me. So, Father, today we call the seed blessed. For the seed brings multiplication.
In the name of Jesus.
The tithe positions, but the seed brings multiplication.
Yes, it
does. Be it unto you according to your faith, for he supplied seed to the sower. Father, take the tithe, the offering, the first fruit on this first Sunday of the month, Lord. Oblations for your glory, Father. First of all, be glorified in it because you said it's holy. You said, Lord, Leviticus 27:30, that the tithe is holy. And you're holy. And now take the seed and bring multiplication and be glorified. And bless the people beyond their wildest imaginations in Jesus' name.
Yes.
I say it again, Encounter Church, you're the best in the Midwest or anywhere else. I speak multiplication upon you. You at home, you can give on PayPal. You can look at the bottom of the screen. You can go to the website. Here in the parking lot, if you'd like a tithing offering envelope, the ushers will help you now. If you'd like an offering envelope for Wednesday, because Wednesday we will not be here in person in the parking lot.
Right.
We will not be here in person. We'll be
Facebook Live only.
Facebook Live only. If you'd like a tithing offering envelope, if you're writing a check, you can make it out to Encounter Church. If you use a credit card, there's information there. There's information there. You can use credit card. There's information there. You can call the church with the information. If you get the machine, we'll call you back. We'll call you back because tomorrow the church office is closed. In observance of Fourth of July, tomorrow the office is closed. But you can still call, leave a message. They'll get back to you.
Yes.
You can come around today. You can come tomorrow morning. You can come today to the black secured mailbox. All of you giving is secured in the kingdom.
Yes.
You can mail a check to the church. This Wednesday, Facebook Live, 7:20, the youth, young adults. And next Sunday, the Lord's Supper. Holy Communion.
Yes.
We thank the Lord for your marvelous Mondays.
Yes, your terrific Tuesdays.
Wonderful Wednesdays.
Tremendous Thursdays.
Fabulous Fridays.
Sensational Saturdays.
And super duper Sunday. Happy 4th of July. Stay safe.
Yes.
Walk in mercy. Show love. This is what's required of all of us. If our arms are long enough,
we'd give you one big hug.
If our lips are big enough,
we'd give you one big kiss.
We love you so much.
We do.
Calvin Church.
You.
We love you so much. Those of you watching, we love you so much. Let's sign off today by giving the Lord a high, healthy, heavenly, holy 4th of July, Independence Day. Let's give the Lord a high, healthy, heavenly, holy hug. Let's do it.